Good morning, children. So yesterday we have seen the multiplication of 5 and 6 digit number, and also we have seen the word problems on the multiplication. Now let us see better division. So in the 4th standard you have learned division by 1 digit number and division by 2 digit number. Now see in your book one conversation is given. Teacher, you have learned something about division. For example, we know that division means making equal parts of a given number or subtracting a number repeatedly from a given number. What else do you know, Shubha? We know that we get 2 divisions from 1 multiplication. From, see, 9 multiplied by 4 equals to 36. So we get the division 36 divided by 4, we get 9, and 36 divided by 9, we get 4. Teacher, very good. Right now, there is nothing new to learn about division. Only the number of digits in the dividend and the divisor will grow. Tell me, what is 354 divided by 6? Sarang, 354 equals to 300 plus 54. And 300 divided by 6 is 50. And 54 divided by 6 is 9. So 50 plus 9 is 59. So 354 divided by 6, the quotient is 59. Right now, let us learn step by step how to divide a 4-digit number by 1-digit number. So let us try better one number, 7,439 by 9. So let us try. So in the 4th standard, you have learned how to divide by 1-digit number. Okay, so let's try. Now, if we take the first number 7, so 7 is smaller than the divisor. So we will take 9 zeros are 0. 7 minus 0, 7. Now we will take down the another number 4. It becomes 74. So 9 8s are 72. Again 4 minus 2, 2, and 7 minus 7, 0. Now see beta, we will take down the another number 3 down. It becomes 23. 9 ones are 9, 2s are 18, and 9 threes are 27. 9 2s are 18. 13 minus 8, 5, and 1 minus 1, 0. Now take down this 9, so it becomes 59. 9, 6 are 9 minus 4, 5, and 5 minus 5, 0. Now see beta, this remainder is smaller than divisor. So we can't divide this 5 by 9. So our quotient is 826 and remainder is 5. So it you have learned in the 4th standard. Now today we will discuss some properties of division. The first property is when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. When a number is divided by 1, the quotient is
quotient. Quotient means answer. After dividing, the answer is quotient. Is the number itself. For example, see beta, 256 divided by 1.
256 divided by 1.
So you will get the same number.
Okay. So if any number is divided by 1, you get the same number or the number itself.
Now second property. When a number divided by itself, when a number is divided by itself, the quotient is one.
When a number is divided by 1, you get the number itself, but a number is divided by itself, we will get 1.
For example, 350 divided by 350, and the answer is, or the quotient is 1.
Got it, beta? And now see the another property.
When 0 is divided by any number, quotient is 0. When 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is zero.
When 0 is divided by any number.
So here 0 is divided by 50.
You will get answer 0. Got it, beta?
And the next property, property number 4. Division by 0 0 is not possible. Means you cannot divide any number by 0. For example, you can't divide 28 divided by 0.
So you say if you divide 28 by 0,
so your answer is
not defined. Means it is not possible.
Or not defined.
Got it, beta? So it is not possible. You can divide any number by 0. Got it, beta? Now the next is division algorithm.
Fifth property. Division algorithm. So what is division algorithm says? Dividend equals to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. Okay, for example, see beta 7 divided by 2. Okay, 2, 3 is 6, 7 minus 6, 1. So this 2 is divisor, it is quotient, it is dividend. And it is remainder. Okay. Dividend. So what is a dividend? 7 equals to divisor multiplied by quotient. Divisor is 2 multiplied by quotient is 3. And plus remainder is 1. 3 2 is 6 plus 1 equals to 7. Again 7. Yes. So what is divisor algorithm? Dividend is equal to divisor multiplied by quotient plus remainder. Got it, children? Okay. So let's solve some questions on division. Got it, beta? Okay, so let's see one question. 729 divided by 37. Got it, children? So it is you have to divide. Now let's try 37. See, if we take the first digit, so we will start division from the left side. Okay, multiplication is start from the right side. So first digit is 7 and our divisor is 37. So dividend is smaller than divisor. So you can't divide 7 by 37. So first we will take 37, 0 is 37, 7. Or you can directly take, without taking this 0, directly we can take the 2 digits. Now, take down this 2. So, let us try 37 ones are 37. 37 twos are. So, we don't know the table of 37, but we will make the table of 37. 37 twos are 74. But here we have 72. So, we will take 37 ones are 37. Now subtract 12 minus 2 minus 7 means 12 minus 7 5 and 6 minus 3 3. So it becomes 35. Okay, now this remainder is smaller than this divisor, but we have 2 digits. So we can't take 2 digits at the same time. So first we will take down this 3. Now this number becomes 353. And here is 37. Okay. So we will try 37 or you can try or you can guess the number. So let us try 37 nines are. 7 nines are 63. 9 threes are 27 plus 6. 33. And here we have 353. 7 nines are 333. 7 tens are 370. Okay. 3 minus 3, 0, 5 minus 3, 2, 3 minus 3, 0. So what it becomes better? It becomes 20. But still we have one digit left. So we will try to take down this. So it becomes 209. Okay. So let us try 37, 5 sir. 5 sevens are 85. Now see, 37 fives are 185 and 37 eights are 296 and 37 fives are 185. Now what we have to take? So we will take 37 fives are 185. Okay, now subtract. 9 minus 5, 4. 10 minus 8, 2. And 1 minus 1, 0. So our remainder is 24. Now see. So we have taken all the digits, so no digit is left in the dividend. And our remainder is smaller than our divisor. So you can't divide 24 by 37. So we will leave this 24 as it is. What is better? So the quotient is 195 and the remainder is 24. Now you can apply here the algorithm, division algorithm. Multiply this 37 and 195 and then add 24 to it. So you will get this dividend. Got it better? So in this way you can apply the division algorithm. Got it better? So let us try one more example. Division by 3-digit number. So here the division by 2-digit number. And then the number is 256 divided by 150. So here the division by 3-digit number. So let's start. See, here is division by 3-digit number. So we can take 3-digit first. Okay, that is 256. 150 and 2-digit is 256. So we will try 256 to the 5 to the 10, 2 ones are 2 plus 1, 230. Okay, and then the first 3 dividend is 256 and 150 to the 230. Now subtract. 6 minus 0, 5 minus 3, and 2 minus 2. Now see, we have 766 digits in the dividend. So take down this 7 down to 150. See, 102 is 230. And 100, if you take 153, so it will greater than this 260. 7. So again we will take 115 twos are 7, 6 minus 3, 3 and 2 minus 4, 0. So what is left with that? 37 is left. Okay. So what is left? 6 minus 0, 0, 7 minus 3, 4. Now one more 6 is left. So we will take down this 6. Now it becomes 466. So let us try. 115 threes are 3 ones are 3 plus 1, 4 and 3 ones are 3. So it is 345, but here is 466. So we will take the next 115 fours up, or you can make the table of 115. 4 plus 4 plus. So it is 460. 4 plus 4 60. 6 plus 0 4 plus 4 0. So what is left, beta? Remainder is 6 left. Now see, and no digits are left over here in the dividend, and the remainder is smaller than this divisor. So we will leave the remainder as it is. So the quotient is 224 and the remainder is 6. So again you can apply the rule of division algorithm. Multiply this 150 and the quotient 224, and whatever the answer, if added to 6, you will get the same number. Got it, beta? So in this way, you can divide by one digit number, two digit number, and three digit number. Got it, beta? So I am giving you some homework to solve. Okay. So homework will send in your group. So bye bye, children.